Welcome back, or welcome for the first time, to TM1 Bytes Weekend Edition. Normally in this time slot we have episodes of Motorsport Manager. However, we are in the interseason between 2017 and 2018 at the moment, and after an entire year of breathing high-octane fumes, Rachel, Max and I have decided to get ourselves a little place in the country to rest and recreate for a little while. We are going to be doing a brief tutorial series on Farm Manager. In this episode, the first of a series of relatively short episodes, we are going to look at creating a new game and setting up a new farm. In later episodes, which will be coming out every 6 hours, we will be looking at the various factors that go into making a successful farm. Let us therefore begin. Okay, so this is the main menu. Continue if you have previously been playing a game. Campaign. Now, the campaign starts out with you taking over your farm, your father's derelict farm. The problem with the campaign is it's as close as you'll get to a tutorial, except for one thing. It doesn't actually teach you anything. You are just expected to know how to do stuff. It does guide you a little bit, but it's not really a tutorial. The scenarios are different scenarios, as the name suggests, where you have to achieve specific objectives. I'm not really a fan of scenarios in management style games, so I'm going to ignore those. Free mode is my weapon of choice. This is where you get to build your own farm on your own land and do whatever you want. Load if you have saved the game previously. Now, if you are logged into your Steam account, this will actually be saved in the cloud, so you can actually load a game from a previous session on another computer if you are switching between computers. Settings. It's worth taking a look at the settings. Now, I'm going to go over to audio. The music volume I had actually previously turned down from 50% to 12%. I just don't like having music playing in the background, and I think it's incredibly distracting for a tutorial, so I'm going to zap that out. The gameplay options, English, Celsius, if you're in North America that'll obviously be Fahrenheit. Scroll on edges doesn't actually work properly in windowed mode, so that's where if you move your mouse cursor up to the top, in theory you go forward, in practice you just sort of a little bit and then you stop, so you really need the WASD keys to move around if you are doing it in a windowed mode. Invert y-axis, I don't think anybody's going to use that. Show tutorial, we'll see what that is in a moment. It's not really a tutorial, it's more like just a set of hints. Mouse sensitivity is going to be standard. In terms of the control, it's worth taking a look through these. There aren't a lot of keys that this game uses. It's actually a pretty straightforward game, but you need to be familiar with at least some of those, but most of them are relatively intuitive. I'm not going to look at credits, but I do know that when I looked at this earlier this morning, although it's the official release game, it just came out a few hours ago actually, the version was shown as 0.9, so there may still be a few bugs in it. I am going to go to the free mode, and I am going to enter this in and come back to you in a moment. Okay, so the farm name is whatever you want to call it, Il Cibo di Kirkus, which is the food of Kirkus. Terrain seed, now this determines what sort of terrain you get. Actually, the terrain is pretty normalized. There's really not that much of a difference in it. But I have put in the terrain seed that I was using in the earlier game when I was just practicing on how to do stuff in here, simply because this way at least I'll know what I'm getting, so I'm not going to have any, oh well, I was going to show you this but the terrain doesn't actually allow it in this case. I have gone for standard difficulty, but I've bumped the cash up to 2 million simply because I have to show you everything in these tutorials, and if I was at 750,000 I'd probably go bankrupt, because you would not in practice build up this fast. You would need to build up a little more slowly. I'm going to apply that and we shall go to our farm. Yes, I sped through that. Now pause immediately. Pause, because you do not want time ticking on while you're figuring out what to do. Offer from the Ministry of Development, build a house for permanent employees before the 24th of July for and it's gone. Now, if you're completely new to the game, that will probably be a little bit annoying, but in reality, you have to build a house for permanent employees anyway, so it's kind of intuitive. Now, Adam will get back to you in a little moment. We have a mini-map down here, which is actually relatively useless because you can see that there is a road running right through the center of your farm, which is in the completely opposite direction in the mini-map. So the mini-map is always oriented in one particular direction, which is not the direction that you start off in. You start off... Oh, now the thing is tilting the way it wasn't before. Okay, you see way down there in the road. I was just scrolling the wheel on my mouse there, and that was actually not working when I did an earlier take of this. Way down the road there, you can see that there is a city, and that's going to be the market for a lot of your goods, and it's also going to be the source of a lot of your supplies. Your farm is just this little staked out area down here at the moment, which has a road running through it, so I'm just going to use the WASD keys because it's the easiest way to move around, it's the only reliable way to move around. So you can see that we have just that small area staked out. We will be able to buy up the other areas later on, but we need to actually grow a decent farm first. One thing that is a bit annoying about this map is that I have seen other ones which have lakes and water supplies nearby, but oh, there's one right down there. So if we expand, or when we expand, we're probably going to want to do it in that direction. Alright, so the first thing that we need to do is take a look around the screen. So we have up here Adam. Hey, I don't know if you remember me. No, I don't remember you. I'm Adam. I don't know you from Adam, Adam. We went to school together. Your father asked me to help you a little on the farm. Okay, Adam, I didn't go to school and I don't have a father. And told me what to pay attention to. Okay, that's nice of you, Adam. To begin with, can I show you where the most important things are? No thanks, Adam. I'll show the people myself. Okay, now Adam's a really nice guy. Whoops, I didn't mean to say start. Oh, go away, Adam. Sorry, I just had to get rid of Adam. Okay, the only thing that Adam really does is show you around the user interface, which I shall show you now. This is all of your construction stuff down here. So this is to plant a field, build a road, build a building, get workers, hire workers, get a chart of the economy, buy machinery, market, which is where you buy and sell various things, including your produce, seeds, and so on and so forth, warehouses, which is where you store stuff which you are going to sell or stuff that you are going to need, and bulldozer to terminate with extreme prejudice anything that you actually don't need. Over here we have three buttons. Photo mode, which is just taking a snapshot of your screen. It's useful when you're in full screen mode when you can't use standard Windows screenshotting. We have a mini map here. You can of course rotate around there using the Q and E keys to realign them, but I don't use the mini map very much, and this of course takes you to your settings. This area we'll come back to in a moment. Up here you have the amount of money that you have. It's got a little funny little F symbol, so I'm just going to call them florins. This shows you how many of your workers are idle. So at the moment we have no workers, therefore none of them are idle. This is observed new resource. It's a way that you can keep track of the most important things in your game. Over here we have the speed controls, as you would expect. The game starts on the 26th of March 2018, which is just after winter in the Northern Hemisphere. Temperature is 1 degree Celsius and it is currently sunny. That's important because of course some crops do not do well in the cold. They don't seem to have any problem with the heat, but of course this is not Australia, otherwise they would die by the dozen. Down here what we have is a list of your current objectives, if you have any. So although this is freeform, you do actually get some objectives given to you where you can gain benefits if you achieve certain goals in a certain amount of time. So at the moment, for example, and we saw this all too briefly before it disappeared, the Department of Development is going to pay you if you build a house for permanent employees. Now, you don't actually make money on that deal because the amount that they pay you is just a proportion of the house, but you need a house for permanent employees anyway. Up here we have a farm owner's house. As with most management games, buildings are the key to what you can and can't do. So if you have certain buildings, you will be able to perform certain tasks, you will be able to upgrade certain things, and so on and so forth. In this game, you cannot do anything until you have a farm owner's house. You can't even check a lot of the things down here, such as the economy thing. It'll say you don't have an owner's building, build one. Okay, now you can actually go down to buildings, and the only thing that you'll be able to build in the houses list is, of course, the farm owner's place. Now this is 80,000 florins. gives access to farm finance management, which is the indicator down there, the economy indicator, staff management, just hiring and firing people, but you do need a place for them to live. Hence, the next thing that you are going to have to build is a house for the workers. An overview of resources in the warehouses, auto trade twice a month. We'll be looking at that in a separate episode regarding the market. Trainings for the owner. I think this was probably written by somebody whose native language is not English. You'll also see monies or revenues or something. Something in plural, which should not be in plural in one of the other dialogues too. Contracts and tasks, which is actually what you have over here. And also fields to a maximum size of 50 meters by 50 meters. So the bigger your farm owner's house, the more you upgrade it to higher levels, the larger the fields that you can build, and also the larger the other resources and buildings in the farm you can build. So we start out at 80,000 as the capital cost, but it also costs us 100 florins per month to run. So you really need to make sure that you are starting to hit revenue as quickly as possible to make sure that you cover the costs for a lot of these buildings. Because if you just build a house and let it sit there, eventually you run out of money. Take a long time now that I've got 2 million euros, but or 2 million florins, but even so. Now notice there's a little red tab on the side of it. I believe that means that it needs to connect to a road. So I am going to build it up here. Now the thing is that if I plonk this down, it does not automatically start building up. What has to happen is that it will become a building construction site, and then materials have to be delivered to build the building. And they will come from the city that we saw earlier on, way up to, I'm going to call it the north, although this doesn't have orientation, and the mini-map would disagree with that as being north. But nonetheless, up at the top of the screen is where the city is, and that's where the materials come from. So they'll get here faster if I actually plonk that down. So I'm going to put that down there. That has actually cleared that tree automatically. Now I'm going to start moving forward, and you see that the hoardings go up around the building side. The only thing that I can build until that is up is a road. So I am actually going to build a road. Now you can build either a paved road or you can build a dirt road. And it says 50% faster or 80% faster. That would presumably be faster than just moving across the grass without a road. So I'm going to build it as a paved road. And I'm going to build it down here. Now the reason for that is that I am going to stick in the workers' houses down here as well. But I can't do that yet because I can't do anything else other than build roads until such time as that is actually built. So I'm going to speed that up a little bit and we'll get the farmer's house built. So you see the truck is now arriving with the materials coming from the what we call north, as I had predicted. Just move down to the S. It will plonk the materials down there. It will take about 1 day in game time to build the house, which is a pretty impressive build rate. But mind you, this game, according to this game, if you plant apple trees, they will be ready to harvest in 300 days. In reality, a dwarf apple tree will take about 4 years before you can start harvesting fruit, and a big-sized apple tree, a normal-sized apple tree, will take 5 to 8 years before you can start harvesting fruit. So, realism may be not the game's strongest point. I'm just going to speed that up again so that we can get the building built. Okay, I really find that to be one hell of an ugly garden. Built success plus 8,000 florins. What does that mean? Okay, remember how we had those objectives, and now we can actually see the objectives, because now if we click on the farmer's house we get access to nothing while I've got the road building, so I'm just going to press escape to get out of that. We get access to this really detailed panel of information, which is essentially command central for running your farm. If you take a look down here in goals, additional missions. So you can see that down here we have offer from the Ministry of Development, build a farm owner's house before the 24th of the 7th. So we've obviously aced that one, it's only the 27th of the 3rd. And get funding to the amount of 8,000 florins. So we had to spend 80,000 to build the house, and then we got 8,000 back from the ministry. Now, we also need to build a house for permanent employees, because we are going to need some employees to work on the farm. We can't do everything ourselves. In fact, we can't do anything ourselves. We can only get employees to do it. So I'm going to go down here to the buildings. Now, these are buildings for animals. These are buildings for people, so the houses. We have a house for seasonal employees, which we don't need just yet. That'll cost us 40,000, but it'll also cost us 100 florins per month. So there is actually no need to do that until we need seasonal employees, which we will. You shall see why later. House for permanent employees. I'm going to leave a little bit of space between the farmhouse and the house for permanent employees, just for privacy's sake. Now you can see again that there is a little tab out there indicating that it needs to be sitting on a road. You can use the angle bracket keys, which are just to the right of your M key, to rotate a building around. You can only do it just in the four directions. This is a very square oriented game. So this will house up to 8 workers, which is as many as we need in the short term. We might need some more a little bit later on. Again, the materials need to be delivered, and after that we can actually get some employees in. Now again, the very kind ministry is going to give us a bit of a rebate on that, so we'll get 3,000 florins once that's actually built. But let's turn our attention to other things that we're going to need. We are going to need to buy in some supplies. Okay, so obviously if we're going to plant fields, we're going to need some seeds, we're going to need fertilizer, we're going to need some pesticide and antifungal agents and so on. And we are also going to need a place to store any goods that we produce for sale. Now, we are going to need a warehouse for that. But before you get carried away and think, oh, well, that's easy, we'll just build a warehouse, you actually need multiple storage facilities for the various different things that you have. So you cannot, for example, store your grains. If you have a field which is producing grains, you cannot store those in your little warehouse. You actually need silos for those. You cannot store silage for your farm animals, or specifically cattle and sheep and so on. I think sheep eat silage. We'll find out anyway. You cannot store that in your warehouse. You need to have a barn for that. None of this is actually laid out to you, but this is why I'm going to be covering it in various different episodes. So I know that I am going to need a general warehouse for storing goods that I have for sale, and also for storing materials that I'm going to need to build my farm. I am going to actually hit the play key so that the trucks will start arriving with the housing materials. I know that I am going to need a silo to store any grains, some of which will be grains that I have produced myself, some of which I will be buying in to feed my animals. I know that I am going to need a barn. I also know that I am going to need a shed to park my, or a garage actually, to park my farm machinery in, and I'm probably going to need just a standard parking place to do that as well. So I am going to build all of those. I think I shall build them down here a little bit. So my intention is to put most of the production areas, the fields and the greenhouses and so on, probably up closer to the worker area, and then have the farm machinery down here, which is going to take them longer to get down to the farm machinery, but they're not going to be using it constantly. And also, they're not necessarily going to be going to the food supplies constantly. Here comes the truck with our building materials, which is all well and good. Okay, so I am going to put in, to start off with, I'm going to put in some parking places for my farm machinery that I am going to buy. Now, I'm not going to build a road. I am going to build a garage, which is here. Now, in terms of garage, we have this small garage for small equipment. It has 6 small size parking spaces. The problem is, most of the stuff that you're going to get is probably not going to fit in there particularly well. Medium brick garage, again, this is for medium agricultural machinery. It has 3 medium parking spaces, which is all well and good. This is probably the better long-term bet. There we go, we've got our house for permanent employees, so I'm actually going to just pause that there, which means that we get our 3,000 florins back. Thank you, the Labour office. Sounds very socialisty. Carport. Okay, so that will fit 3 large machines in. Or you can just plonk them down a parking space. So this will fit 4, but it has no cover. Now, I haven't actually proven this yet because, I mean, I've only had the game for about 5 hours. I suspect that if you leave your equipment parked out in the open, it's probably going to weather and decay faster than other machinery, and therefore it's going to need repairs faster. So I shall build a parking space, but I'm going to build a carport first so that I can put stuff like my tractor in, the high value items I'm going to put into the carport. Now that's going to cost me 45,000 as opposed to 50,000 just for the slab. Why? The slab will fit 4 units, whereas this will only fit 3. This will cost me 50 florins a month to run. That will only cost me 10. But even so, I would prefer to have my tractor undercover. So I am going to park my tractor down here. I'll use the angle bracket keys to rotate that around. And what I'll do is stick a road down there so that we have a roadway leading up there. So I'm going to plant that down there. I'll actually start that forward just so that we can get the hoardings up. So I shall put a road through here. It shall be a paved road. So that's okay there. So that will give us access to all of these areas. I will now put up a new parking lot. So let's go over to here. I'll just put this down as a parking slab for the moment. I may live to regret this because I'm going to need more than 3 pieces of machinery, but there'll be a separate episode on that once we start looking at creating fields, and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about there. Now, in terms of the warehouse, the problem with the warehouse is you don't want it to necessarily be too far from your fields because your employees are going to have to be making deliveries to it on a regular basis. So I think I shall put the warehouse in a little bit closer up here, and I'll have it facing the main road. So I shall go and build the warehouse. With the amount of money that I've got, I don't have to worry too much about it. You will need a small warehouse. Now, this will not cover you for everything. As I said, you can see down there it'll store seeds and plants, which is good, fruits and vegetables, which is good, dairy, others, bottles and jars, dry good, agrochemicals. What it will not store are seeds, plants, hay and straw, haylages, which is things like silage for your cattle. You actually need to have that. You can't buy in silage without having a barn. And down here at 190,000 warehouse with cooling, you cannot have meat until you have one of these, because the little warehouse cannot store meat. It is not designed for storing meat and frozen foods. So that's what you're going to need. Later on, you can actually have factories as well, which can produce things such as juice and so on, but that's a little bit further down the track. So I'm going to put in a small warehouse, let's say about halfway down, and I can build stuff up around it. Now I'm going to need a barn as well. I shall unpause that so that we get the hoarding up. I'm going to put a road down the side there, which it would help if I told it what sort of road I want. So I'm going to move that down there. And then I am going to put up a barn, and that will allow me to. That is not a barn. That is not. Okay, that is a barn. Okay, right there. Now that will allow me to store feed for my animals as well as chemicals, seeds, everything I could possibly need. And I'll just rotate that around there so that the little tab is facing towards the road. Okay, click on that, and that will become a hoarding as well. I actually want to build a silo as well. So the reason for that is I'm going to need that to store grains. That's a medium silo for the storage of grains. That will allow me to store 200,000. And you're not limited to one type of grain per silo, which I'm not sure is particularly realistic, but even so. So that will store not only the grains that I buy in for my animals, which I am going to get some animals, but it will also store anything that I harvest in the way of grains. So I'm going to go for the larger silo because I can afford it with my 2 million, which is rapidly depleting, of course. I'll just shove that across there, and that will be fine and good. So I am going to speed that up a little bit. Now you can see as they're building, the little green bar goes up around the hammer icon. So that tells you how far they have completed this. So this is now fully completed. That's now fully completed. That's now fully completed. Sorry, that's not, but that is. That will be in a moment, hopefully. Should be. 1st of April, I think. Possibly we pause there for an autosave. Okay, I'm going to go back to standard speed because obviously we want to start getting stuff moving. Okay, we can see down here we now have hire any employee. So we're going to be looking at employees in a little more detail in a later episode, but we might as well get that out of the way first. The offer from the Labour Office, hire any employee before the 27th of the 7th and get a reward of 1,000 florins. In fact, I don't think we'll do that in this episode. We've got our farm set up so that we actually have the house, we have the workers' accommodation, we have everything we need for storage. The next step will be to hire some employees, get ourselves some farm equipment, build ourselves some fields, build ourselves some greenhouses. All of this would take a very long time indeed in a single episode. So what I am going to do is break these up into mini bite episodes so that you can watch through the part that you're particularly interested in. They'll be going up every 6 hours or so over the next couple of days until we have looked at everything we could possibly look at up to a certain point, because I think as the game goes on, things will get more advanced and there will probably be more to look at. But my intention is to cover the entire basics of the game in about 12 episodes, and then we shall look at doing more advanced episodes possibly later on down the line if these get a sufficient viewership. Speaking of which, if you would be so kind as to click on the like button, it would be very much appreciated. It tells YouTube that you actually found this episode useful and or interesting, and that you want to see more of them. It tells me that as well. If you would like to subscribe, please feel free to do so. If you want to be notified as new episodes come out, hit the little bell button, and comment if you would like to do so. But that is your bite for the next 6 hours. So until 6 hours from now, have a great Saturday, and goodbye.